Welcome to Jacket Time TV. I am Ashley Tucker. This is our inaugural broadcast brought to you by Fairview FFA's Agricultural Communications team. This media studio was purchased by the Department of Career Tech through a technology grant. Our goal is to broadcast every 3 to 4 weeks, showcasing student and community involvement. Each broadcast will be developed, produced, and edited by the Fairview Agricultural Communications team. Now switching gears, anchor Kara Schlotthauer would like to recognize some of our recent ag achievements by our FFA chapter.
The Fairview FFA chapter has earned several prestigious awards this past year. The Fairview Agricultural Education Program was recently recognized as a top 6 program in the nation out of more than 7,000 programs. Mr. McGolden and Mr. Lundry will receive this award on behalf of the FFA program at the NAAE National Conference in New Orleans. Ashley Tucker and Shanna Lanley were recognized as national finalists in the FFA Agri-Science Fair. They will compete at the National FFA Convention in October. Will Church was also chosen to represent the entire Northwest District as president during the opening ceremonies of the Northwest District Colt Conference. The Fairview FFA chapter has also been awarded the 3-star National Emblem Chapter Award, which is only given to the top 2% of all chapters in the nation. Congratulations to everyone in the Fairview FFA chapter for your hard work. It's a great way to start out the year. And now we'll go to Maggie Martins for an interview with Coach Bernard.
Hello, I'm Maggie Martins, and I'm here with Coach Bernard. Coach, this is your 4th year coaching here at Fairview, but your first year as head football coach. What are you most excited for?
I'd say I'm most excited about just being out there with the guys. I've been around football my whole life since I was in kindergarten. You know, my dad was a football coach, so every year when football rolled around, it was just something that me and him did together. So I'm just excited to be out there and being with the guys and getting better every day.
Coach, you guys lost 11 seniors last year. What are you expecting out of the players this year to fill those roles?
I think they have to step into some roles that maybe some of them aren't comfortable with. Some of us are juniors and we're inexperienced, but they've been working hard and hopefully they can fill those roles.
We have some game footage here. Last Friday, you guys managed a 57-0 victory over OBA. What went well for you?
You know, early I think we struggled with some nerves, and that goes back to being inexperienced with some of those guys. But I overcame some of that adversity. And, ended up playing well in the second, third, and fourth quarters and moved the ball well, executed well, did everything that we'd worked on throughout the week.
And your next opponent, Chisholm, you play tonight. What is your biggest challenge facing them?
Chisholm's a good football team. They obviously they have some returning guys that are pretty good. They're very physical, big up front, like to be able to run the ball. They run the jet sweep well. They throw the ball well, so we're going to have to be especially early in the game, we're going to have to be very focused and very in tune with what we're trying to do to give ourselves a chance to win.
All right, and before we go, a fun question. What is your favorite high school football memory?
Favorite memory would probably be my sophomore year of high school, first round of the playoffs. We were down 7-0 with about a minute to go in the game. It was 4th and 23, about the 50-yard line. And we completed a long pass and ended up scoring a touchdown on that play and then baked the extra point and won 8-7.
Wow, that sounds like a very interesting game. So tonight, Fairview versus Chisholm at 7:30, Eubanks Field, and then afterwards, there's going to be a 5th quarter at the Fairview Mennonite Brethren Youth Building for high schoolers. It's going to be fun. We're going to have karaoke and food. So be there or be square.
Did you know that over $1,000 was raised by Fairview High School by simply recycling items that would usually be considered trash? FHS has been named the top state qualifier twice for TerraCycle Brigades, which are specific item waste streams. Students and community members can help by simply collecting items such as empty shampoo bottles and cereal bags. Even the cap from your Coke bottle can be converted to cash for our school. Want to help? Be on the lookout for drop-off boxes placed around the high school and stay alert for more information coming up on our next broadcast.
Each one of our bi-weekly shows, we will be giving you the next 2 weeks' worth of activities in our school. So starting on Monday the 14th, there's a fast pitch softball game at Ringwood that starts at 4:30. There's a 6th grade football game versus Chisholm that starts at 6. A JV football game versus Chisholm that starts at 7. And a junior high fast pitch softball game at Alva that starts at 4:30. On Tuesday, there's a fast pitch softball game versus OBA, and there's also open house. So the elementary school open house starts at 6:30 and goes through 7:30. The middle school starts at 7 and goes through 8, and the high school's is from 7:30 to 8:30. Wednesday, it is middle school's picture day. There's a club meeting, med meeting at lunch, and there's an FCCLA officer training at Stillwater. Thursday, there's a fast pitch softball game at the Hinton Tournament, and the State Fair of Oklahoma starts. There's also a junior high fast pitch softball game versus Watonga. On Friday the 18th, the State Fair of Oklahoma continues, and there's a football game at Watonga that starts at 7:30. On Saturday the 19th, the State Fair of Oklahoma continues once more, and there's a cross-country meet at La Mega that starts at 8:30 a.m.
And on Monday the 21st, there is a fast-pitch softball game versus Hennessy at 4:30, and a 6th grade football game at Watonga at 5 o'clock, and junior high football at Watonga at 6:30. On Tuesday, the FFA Northwestern Cult Conference at Enid and the Cornelson Elementary Picture Day. And on Wednesday, FCCLA Blood Drive. And on Thursday, the Fast Pitch Softball District Tournament and the 8th grade opening ceremonies and the FHS Picture Day. And on Friday, the Fast Pitch Softball District Tournament and the State Fair at Oklahoma City and football versus Moreland at 7 with a speech meal and band coordination at the game. And on Saturday, cross country at OSU Jamboree. And to stay on the update with all the Fairview Schools activities, you can find those on the fairviewhigh.com website.
We will now take a moment to remember those who lost their lives 14 years ago today on September 11th, 2001. Let us never forget those who lost their lives on that tragic day. Thank you for tuning in to our first broadcast of Jacket Time TV. See you next time.